एवरीवन, वेलकम टू एनालिस्ट आईएएस। सो दिस इज द फिफ्थ एपिसोड ऑफ इम्पॉर्टेंट हिस्ट्री क्वेश्चन डिस्कशन सीरीज फॉर यूपीएससी प्रीलिम्स 2022। सो लेट्स स्टार्ट द वीडियो। सो क्वेश्चन नंबर वन इज कंसीडर द फॉलोइंग स्टेटमेंट्स। स्टेटमेंट नंबर वन, इन द रेवेन्यू एडमिनिस्ट्रेशन ऑफ दिल्ली सल्तनत द इंचार्ज ऑफ रेवेन्यू कलेक्शन वॉज नोन एज आमिल। स्टेटमेंट नंबर टू, The Ikta system of Sultans of Delhi was an ancient indigenous institution. Statement number 3, The office of Mir Bakshi came into existence during the reign of Khilji Sultans of Delhi. Which of the statements given above is are correct? Option A, one only. Option B, one and two only. Option C, three only. Or option D, one, two and three. So answer of this question is option A. Statement number 1 is correct. Now let's see the explanation. In the Delhi Sultanate, the task of collecting revenue directly from peasant and measurement of land rested on amils. Ikta system evolved in West Asia, significantly in Persia. Mir Bakshi was the head of military department in Mughal India, whereas in Delhi Sultanate, Aris under Diwan-e-Arz that was set up by Balban was improved by Alauddin Khilji as he introduced Dag system which was aimed to improve horse quality as well as eliminate fake numbering. Now let's move to the next question. So question number 2 is consider the following statements. Statement number 1, Sant Nimbarka was a contemporary of Akbar. Statement number 2, Sant Kabir was greatly influenced by Sheikh Ahmad Sar Hindi. Which of the statements given above is are correct? Option A, one only. Option B, two only. Option C, both one and two. Or option D, neither one nor two. So answer of this question is option D, neither one nor two. Now let's see the explanation. Nimbarka was a 13th century philosophical saint, whereas Akbar's time period was 1556 to 1605. Saint Kabir was 15th century poet, whereas Sir Hindi was in 17th century. Now let's move to the next question. So question number 3 is, with reference to British colonial rule in India, consider the following statements. Statement number 1, Mahatma Gandhi was instrumental in the abolition of the system of indentured labor. Statement number 2, in Lord Chelmsford War Conference, Mahatma Gandhi did not support the resolution on recruiting Indians for World War. Statement number 3, consequent upon the breaking of salt law by Indian people, the Indian National Congress was declared illegal by the colonial rulers. Which of the statements given above are correct? Option A, 1 and 2 only. Option B, 1 and 3 only. Option C, 2 and 3 only. Or option D, 1, 2 and 3. So answer of this question is option B. Statement number 1 and 3 are correct. Now let's see the explanation. In South Africa, Gandhi, in opposition to compulsory registration of Indian population under Asiatic Law Amendment Act of the Transvaal government, organized non-violent protest which led to passing of Indian Relief Act 1914, which eliminated extra tax on Indian citizens who had not renewed their indentures and recognized validity of Indian marriages. In the Young India article dated 27 November 1920 to every Englishman in India, Gandhi quoted his recruiting campaign which was carried out in Kaira district, that is in Gujarat, in support of British cause in World War I, according to the promise made in War Conference of Delhi. As the salt march ended in month of April 1930, between June and August, several Congress working committees and leaders were arrested and Congress as a political was declared illegal by the British administration. Now let's move to the next question. So question number 4 is, with reference to Indian national movement, consider the following pairs, person and position held. Number 1, Sir Tej Bahadur Sapru, President, All India Liberal Federation. Number 2, K.C. Niyogi, Member, the Constituent Assembly. Number 3, P.C. Joshi, General Secretary, Communist Party of India. Which of the pairs given above is are correctly matched? Option A, one only. Option B, one and two only. Option C, three only. Or option D, one, two and three. So answer of this question is option D, one, two and three. Let's see the explanation. Tej Bahadur Sapru was a prominent member of Liberal Party of India and the president of All India Liberal Federation. K.C. Niyogi was a member of Constituent Assembly and also the chairman of First Finance Commission. P.C. Joshi was the general secretary of Communist Party of India. Now let's move to the next question. So question number 5 is, with reference to Mian Tansen, which one of the following statements is not correct? Option A, Tansen was the title given to him by Emperor Akbar. Option B, Tansen composed Drupads on Hindu gods and goddess. Option C, Tansen composed songs on his patrons. Option D, Tansen invented many rags. So answer of this question is option A, Tansen was the title given to him by Emperor Akbar, is incorrect. Now let's see the explanation. Tansen was the title given by Raja Vikramajit of Gwalior. Tansen was a court musician in the Darbar of Raja Ramchandra of Bandhavgarh. Now let's move to the next question. So question number 6 is, who among the following Mughal emperors shifted emphasis from illustrated manuscripts to album and individual portraits? Option A, Humayun. Option B, Akbar. Option C, Jahangir. Or option D, Shahjahan. So answer of this question is option C, Jahangir. Now let's see the explanation. During Akbar's reign, many manuscripts were illustrated. The prominent being Razmnama, the Persian translation of Mahabharata. It was during Jahangir's reign that manuscripts became less important and individual portraits became more prominent. So that's all for today. We'll meet you soon with the next episode of the series. Stay connected. Thank you.